Thank you for attending CME for Life's board review course. These are, as promised, the trigger slides. Make sure these all pop in your mind. We know that the parasympathetic nervous system is like the leash of the dog. The dog is the sympathetic nervous system. We cut the leash with atropine. We stimulate the leash with adenosine or vagal maneuvers. We know that seeing a shark is like having an adrenaline rush. It's a sympathetic state. It makes your heartbeat faster, makes your lungs dilate, makes your pupils dilate, makes your blood pressure go up. You have to know the adrenal hormones. Remember, cortisol raises blood sugar and gives you a leukocytosis. We know that aldosterone has you retain volume. It retains sodium and fluid. And we know that epinephrine drives your diastolic blood pressure. We know that Aldo, he kicks out potassium. So aldosterone retains sodium, kicks out potassium. Funnel drugs slows down conduction at your AV node. That's beta blockers, calcium channel blockers, and digoxin. We know that if it ends in pine, that's a dihydropyridine calcium channel blocker. It dilates blood vessels, it dies. It doesn't slow down conduction. Digoxin is like putting your truck into low gear. The truck will go slower but with more force. Remember, stimulating the vagus nerve makes the heart go slow. That's vasovagal syncope. If we cut the vagus nerve, remember that is atropine. Atropine makes the heart go faster. The anticholinergic side effects, blind as a bat, mad as a hatter, dry as a bone, red as a beet, and hot as heat. Remember, anticholinergic side effects get you in trouble with glaucoma patients and people who are excessively dry, like Sjogren's syndrome. How do we cut the vagus nerve? Atropine. How do we stimulate it? Adenosine or vagal maneuvers. Remember, repetition is the mother of skill. Remember, the key ACLS medicines start with the letter A. Look at the second letter. Remember, atropine makes the heart tachycardic, adenosine slows down the heart, and amiodarone mellows out the heart. Here is a summary of the autonomic nervous system. Remember, the sympathetic nervous system has two major receptors, the alpha and the beta receptor. You have to know what stimulating them means. And if I stimulate the parasympathetic nervous system, it makes you super relaxed. So the T wave is very important because it's phase one of hyperkalemia, and the heart is very vulnerable to being shocked there. Therefore, we have any patient with a unstable tachyarrhythmia, we do a synchronized shock. There are four major side effects of amiodarone: eye, thigh, liver, lung, optic neuritis, thyroid disease, hepatitis, pulmonary fibrosis. There are four cardiomyopathies: dilated cardiomyopathy, hypertrophic cardiomyopathy, restricted cardiomyopathy, and Takotsubo's or scared heart or broken heart syndrome. Remember, an S3 has a dilated left ventricle. We see that with CHF and dilated cardiomyopathy. The linking technique for dilated cardiomyopathy is men, medicines like Adriamycin, alcohol, thyroid, pregnancy, and infections. That's a linking technique. CHF, 1, 2, 3, 4. Number 1 is JVD. Number 2 is hepatojugular reflux, ascites, edema. Number 3 is S3 and a mitral regurg murmur. Number 4, rales or pulmonary symptoms with redistribution symptoms. Remember, all of these should be popping in your brain from our live conference. Pain with supine. Remember, that can be pericarditis, biliary colic, or GERD. If they say pain at night, you have to think it's one of those three. Remember, CHF doesn't hurt more at night. They just get more symptomatic at night. ST segment elevation, the mnemonic is APPLE, A-P-P-L-E. You have to know the first three, which is acute myocardial infarction, Prinz metal, and pericarditis. JVD, there are three causes of JVD. That's CHF, pericardial tamponade, and tension pneumothorax, and you have to know the difference between pericardial tamponade and tension pneumothorax. Beck's triad, and all has to do with is the trachea midline, and what are the lung sounds? Remember, in South Vietnam, there's MIA, so the major systolic murmurs are mitral insufficiency and aortic stenosis. The major diastolic murmurs are aortic insufficiency and mitral stenosis. There's only three major rhythms, sinus, fibs, and tachs, but there's two in each category, so you have to talk to them about sinus brady and sinus tachycardia. You have to talk about atrial fibrillation and ventricular fibrillation, and you have to talk about the two tachs, SVT and VT, okay, ventricular tachycardia. Remember, the causes of sinus tachycardia, you can't get fat and Hades, P-H-A-T, pain, hypovolemia, anxiety, and temp. Hades, hypoxia, anemia, drug overdoses, ETOH or opiate withdrawal, and S is a systemic problem, so you can't get fat and Hades. Remember, you have to understand fat, pain, hypovolemia, anxiety, and temp by far is the most common. AFib, narrow complex, no P waves, or if you actually give you measure, if the boards gave you a measurement, it'd be about 500 beats per minute, always irregular. How do we treat AFib? Keep it slow, less than 100, prevent embolic phenomena, so prevent the heart from shooting up BBs, and try to convert it back to sinus rhythm. Remember, the P wave rate of fib is about 500, the P wave rate of flutter is about 300. SVT, we treat it by stimulating the vagus nerve with either adenosine or vagal maneuvers. VTAC is a Bon Jovi rhythm. Remember, how do these people present? Dead or alive. So dead people, we defibrillate. We do an unsynchronized shock. If they're alive and unstable, we do a synchronized shock. If they're alive and stable, use medicines like procainamide or amiodarone. The triptylenes, amitriptyline or nortriptyline. If someone overdoses, they'll have anticholinergic side effects and wide complex QRSs. We treat that with sodium bicarb. The mechanical model of treating CHF, we can either strengthen the heart, which is the donkey, unload the wagon, which represents preload, and we do the diuretics or nitro, or we can change the pitch of the slope, which is vasodilation, and that is the money. Acutely, we vasodilate with nitro. Chronically, we dilate with ACEs and ARBs. There are two types of heart failure, right heart failure and left heart failure. Right heart failure is roads, so what roads lead to the heart? Superior and inferior vena cava. Left heart symptoms are lungs. That's pulmonary symptoms and redistribution symptoms. Remember, the 12 causes of secondary hypertension, pseudotumorous rebri, sleep apnea, thyroid, parathyroid, Cushing's, hyperaldosteronism, pheochromocytoma, intrinsic renal, renal artery stenosis, and then pregnancy, high estrogen states, and coartation. Remember, there are only three major classes of antihypertensives, diuretics, dilators, and blockers. Please make sure you memorize SLUR as the mnemonic for hydrochlorothiazide. Sugars, lipids, uric acids, and renal patients. There are five causes of chest pain. The first two, pericarditis and acute coronary syndrome, come on gradually. The bottom three all come on acutely. Pneumothorax, acute onset PE, acute onset thoracic aortic dissection, acute onset. The cardiac risk factors, the arterial risk factors, SAD, CHF, smoking age, diabetes, cholesterol, hypertension, and family history. Remember, there's three acute coronary syndromes. Unstable angina, STEMI, and non-STEMI. We rule out a STEMI by an EKG. We rule out non-STEMI by troponins. We rule out unstable angina by non-invasive stress testing. Why do cardiac patients die? Either from CHF or lethal arrhythmia. So if someone has a heart attack, they're going to go into failure. Well, how do we treat failure? LMNOP, Lasix, morphine, nitrates, oxygen, and BiPAP or pressure. How do we treat lethal arrhythmia? We shock them. The salicylate shuffle. Please remember the salicylate shuffle. Remember, Kussmaul breathing. It's an antiplatelet. No with kids because of Reye syndrome unless they have Kawasaki's disease. We use this with Tequervaines, subacute thyroiditis, and we know that Tequervaines is linked to the Finkelstein test. I'm wondering right now, as I'm talking you through this, are you actually going through the hand gestures? I'm going to start over. Remember, Kussmaul breathing, antiplatelets. We don't use it in kids unless they have Cushing's disease. We use it with Dequervaine subacute thyroiditis. We know that Dequervaine is linked to the Finkelstein test. We use it with the flushing of niacin, nasal polyps we're concerned about because of Samter's triad, and tinnitus. It's the most common medication to give you tinnitus. Remember, there are five different kinds of germs, gram-positive, gram-negatives, atypicals, anaerobes, and pseudomonas. You have to know the three gram-positives, and you got to know the three atypicals. And then you got to talk about E. coli, Neisseria. Those are the common gram-negatives that you got to know. Strep, there are five different types of strep. You have to talk about strep viridans and endocarditis. You got to talk about pyogenes and strep throat. Pneumococcus, which is strep pneumoniae, enterococcus, and bovis. So please make sure you're remembering the buzzwords from the five different kinds of strep. Remember the endocarditis presentations. Roth spots are on the retina. Splinter hemorrhage is on the fingernail. And OJ, remember Ostler's nodes, ouch. Janeway's lesions do not hurt. Strep throat, remember Center's criteria, CENT, cough, exudates, nodes, and temp. Or maybe they have mono. Staph aureus, remember we created the beta-lactamase penicillins to kill methicillin-sensitive Staph aureus, and that's imetanastiox, methicillin, nafcillin, and oxacillin. Here is Staph. They're all clustered in together. Remember, Staph is in clusters, strep is in chains. Remember, strep is like a strap. That cat up on top means that strep is catalase positive. Clostridium, there's four different species of Clostridium. DPT, that's where it starts. So you have Clostridium difficile, Clostridium perfringens, Clostridium tetani, and Clostridium botulinum. Okay, there's four different forms of strep. They're very relevant for your boards. Gram-negative rods, they're anaerobes. Remember, if you have a newborn that's TTSing, listeria. Listeria. How do we treat a newborn that's TTSing? Ampicillin and cefotaxime. If you have gram-negative diplococci, it's Neisseria that causes meningitis, the really bad form that we prophylact close contacts with either ciprofloxacin, and it causes a gonococcal urethritis that we treat with ceftriaxone 250 times 1 IM. Remember, dogs and cats are in the pasture. Pastorella is from dog bites and cat bites. Very aggressive onset, we treat with Augmentin. All bites, we get followed up the next day. Salmonella is pea green diarrhea. Salmonella can give sickle cell anemic patients osteomyelitis. If they say anything about osteomyelitis on the boards, you want to say NAFSIL in 6 weeks. MCL, these are your atypical germs, Mycoplasma, Chlamydia, Legionella. Reiter syndrome is I can't see, can't pee, and can't climb a tree. HLA-B27. Remember the pediatric rashes. Let's go roseola, starts in the thorax and goes through the face. High fevers, slap cheeked appearances, erythema infectiosum, parvovirus B19. Rubella, that's my dog Bella. He's a German dog. German measles is bad on pregnant women. Remember, he only bites pregnant women. Remember, chicken pox, it is highly contagious to people who have never been immunized or do not have chicken pox. But the zoster is not highly contagious. Remember, that's my friend Juan who's singing hola. That's Ruby. Hola. That is measles. And they have Koplik spots. And last one is hand, foot, and mouth disease. So these are the major six pediatric rashes. Remember, squamous cell is for 16, HPV 16. Cervical cancer with squamous cell is 16. 18 is adeno. Remember the major antibiotics. We have CVG. So we have clindamycin, vancomycin, gentamicin, the two M's, which is metronidazole and macrodantin. The two T's are tetracycline and trimethoprim sulfamexazole. Then green, we have the penicillin cephalosporins, and blue, we have fluoroquinolones and macrolides. Vancomycin is only good for gram positives. It's like an ambulance, right? Vancomycin is the gold standard for MRSA infections. Gentamicin, you think he's a gentleman, but he's a cheap fighter, right? He boxes your ears and punches in your kidneys. Ototoxic, nephrotoxic. Remember, if it's flagellated, use Flagyl or metronidazole. Isoniazid, INH, I need B6, neuropathy, hepatitis, and they get a Mallard-like rash or the lupus-like rash. Do you remember the six medicines that give you a lupus-like rash? M and Q put a chip in the agent. Ethambutol gives you optic neuritis. The pulmonary complaints, or the pulmonary symptoms on your boards, the pulmonary buzzwords. HORID, H-O-R-I-D. There's only five causes of pulmonary symptoms. Ladies and gentlemen, this will save lives. Anybody with a cough, heart obstruction reaction infection, or could it be a PE or pneumothorax? Remember, there's three lung sounds. Ronchi is the green gook in the big airways. That means bronchitis. If there's fluid at the alveolar level, that's rails or crackles, that's pus or water, pneumonia, CHF. And if the lungs are clamped down, if there's wheezing, it's reactive airway disease. You have steeple sign versus thumbprint sign. Steeple sign is croup. We treat with steroids, dexamethasone. Thumbprint sign is epiglottitis. You proceed with caution and you get ENT involved. There are two pulmonary tumors that give you hemoptysis. That's squamous cell and adeno. Scratch it. I made a mistake. It's not squamous cell and adeno. Squamous cell and oat cell. Remember, adeno does not give you hemoptysis. Asthma, treat them while they're making noise. Nebulizers, oxygen, IV fluids, steroids. Epinephrine is more like a third-line agent. Remember this, guys. Klaus's clarification. You have to understand how to do blood gases. It's a big deal. How to understand acid-base. Go through this. If you have to pause this video, make sure you can master Klaus's clarification. Where did the person get sick? If it's community acquired, it's MASH. Remember the germs. Moraxella catarrhalis, atypical strep pneumonia H flu. If it's hospital acquired, it's peas, Pseudomonas, E. coli, anaerobes, and staph. Bottom line is, healthcare acquired pneumonia, it's a triple regime. Vancomycin, piperacillin, tazobactam, or vancozocin. Community acquired pneumonia outpatient, I want you to think doxier, clarithromycin, which is Biaxin. We're inpatient is ceftriaxone and azithromycin. Remember, PERC rules. That's the two Vs, Virchow's triad, vital signs. Hemoptysis, age, they've got to be less than 50, and signs of a deep venous thrombosis. DISH, these are the venous risk factors. Damage, stasis, hypercoagulable state. Remember, the major venous diseases are DVT, PE, and Budd-Chiari syndrome. Whale of a PE, that's a whale of a PE. So what are the radiographic findings of a PE? Whale, Western Mark St. Hampton's hump, atelectasis, lovely, and effusions. Hampton hump is the one you have to know. GI. Remember, Normal squamous cell goes to columnar epithelial, that is Barrett's esophagus, that mets to adenocarcinoma. Kress syndrome, calcinosis, Raynaud's esophagus, motility, sclerodactyly, telangiectasias. That penny means we use the anti-centromere antibody to make this diagnosis. This is part of scleroderma. Plummer-Vincent syndrome is colonychia, esophageal webs, glossitis, and dysphagia. We know that H. pylori causes adenocarcinoma, lymphoma, and ulcers. Charcot's triad is a yellow M&M with charcoal and a temperature. So remember, Charcot's triad is right up a quadrant pain, jaundice, and fever. Reynolds pentad is if you wrap him up and he becomes hypotensive with altered mental status. That's a septic Charcot's triad. So Reynolds pentad is Charcot's triad with altered mental status and hypotension. Ranson's criteria, gall, ETOH, glucose, age, leukocytosis, liver functions, ETOH, electrolytes, third spacing, oxygen, and hematocrit. The hepatitis antigens and antibodies, envelope, core, and surface. Remember, the envelope is the earliest. You have antibodies. So you have antibodies to all of the antigens. Know that anybody who had the tetanus shots will have antibodies to the hepatitis B surface antigen. Remember this picture, guys. Crohn's is more on the right. PROM stands for the key features of appendicitis, PROM. So West sign, Rob Singh sign, obturators, McBurney's points. Sister Mary Joseph nodule is with adenocarcinoma stomach, and UC Davis is more on the left. Musculoskeletal. Remember, Thomas Jefferson was the number one president, and he taps people on the head to say, you're a good boy. So Jefferson fracture is number one, and it's axial loading. Hill-Sack is on the humerus. Salter fractures, S-A-L-T-E-R, simple, above, lower, through, and EGADS. Make sure you know the difference between a Salter 2 and a Salter 3. Montesia fracture is an ulnar fracture. Galeazzi is a radius fracture. HLA-B27 is linked to ankylosing spondylitis and Reiter's syndrome. Remember, Skiffy is a frog leg lateral pelvis. Skiffy is the 13-year-old football player. Multiple myeloma is lytic lesions that spill calcium and protein into the blood. The protein goes to the kidney and gives you acute renal failure, and you pee out Bence-Jones proteins. The swan is eating the frog. Swan neck deformity, EF, extension, flexion, where the boot is on the feet. Boutonniere deformity is flexion, extension. Remember, ouch, gout, ouch. Gout is rod-shaped and negative, beneficently shaped crystals. Pseudogout is rhomboid and positively beneficently shaped crystals. Remember this mnemonic for rheumatoid, the rheumatologic conditions. Sjogren's syndrome, polyarteritis nodosa. Lupus, polymyalgia rheumatica. Scleroderma, where Kress syndrome is, polymyositis. Fibromyalgia, gout, rheumatoid arthritis, and Reiter's syndrome. Polyarteritis nodosa is linked to hepatitis B. Lupus is linked to a false positive syphilis test. Polymyalgia rheumatica is linked to temporal arteritis. Scleroderma is linked to Kress syndrome. Polymyositis is linked to dermatomyositis. Okay, those are the hot buzzwords. Psych. Remember, if you're looking for major depression, you're looking for five of Sigi caps. Sleep, changes, interest, guilt, energy, concentration, appetite, psychomotor, or suicide ideations. The manic phases are dig fast, distractibility, insomnia, grandiose, flight of ideas, activities or agitation, sexual indiscretions, and talkativeness. Remember the personality disorders, A, B, and C. Pass hand by the DOA. It's paranoid, schizoid, schizotypal, histrionic, antisocial, narcissistic, borderline, dependent, obsessive-compulsive disorder. Remember, obsessive-compulsive disorder, these people are egocentric as opposed to obsessive-compulsive. Obsessive-compulsive personality disorder, they're ego-dystonic. If it's obsessive-compulsive disorder, they're ego-syntonic. Holy cow, scratch that. I'm saying it backwards. I apologize. If it's a personality disorder, remember, they're ego-syntonic. If it's an obsessive-compulsive disorder, they're ego-dystonic. And A is avoidant. Alcoholism, look at all the buzzwords, guys. Pancreatitis, do you remember Ranson's criteria? Bleeding esophageal varices, I want you to think octreotide. How do you prevent delirious tremens? Benzos. Dilated cardiomyopathy. Do you remember the linking technique? They're classically macrocytic. Remember, they have Klebsiella pneumonia, current jelly sputum. If it's current jelly stool, it's intussusception. Any alcoholic that falls, you got to scan their head because they have subdural hematomas. Risk of suicide is sad persons. Male sex, young or old, history of depression. Have you ever attempted it before? Alcohol or substance abuse, rational thought loss, which is schizophrenia, social support lacking, always organized plan, which remember, in my conference, I stressed how important that is, no spouse or sickness, and if they have access to a gun, that's the lethal form of suicide that makes them even more risky. Let's talk about the blood. Sideroblastic rings comes from alcohol, lead, and isoniazide. Basophilic stippling comes from lead and thalassemia. So, lead is sideroblastic rings and basophilic stippling. Ferritin level locks in the diagnosis for iron deficiency anemia. Our rods is AML. Philadelphia chromosome is CML. Swollen lymph nodes in the neck, if you're thinking Hodgkin's, it's Reed-Sternberg cells. Coombs test is for hemolytic anemia. Let's talk about ENT. Remember, a Chalazion is off the road, it's painless, they got to go to ophthalmology. A Hordeolum or sty is on the road, it's painful, it's symptomatic treatment. Wilson's disease is a copper excess Kieser-Fleisser rings of the eye. Weber test will lateralize to the side of hearing loss. Remember that humming drill that we did. Endocrine, remember, thyroid disease, Graves' disease, and De Quervain's are classically hyperthyroid. In the middle is your thyroiditis, which is Hashimoto's and De Quervain's. Remember, De Quervain's we treat with aspirin. But that asterisk by De Quervain means that sometimes they're hypothyroid, sometimes they're hyperthyroid. And the Himalaya Mountains, HIML, is for the hypothyroid states. The H stands for Hashimoto's. I is iatrogenic. M is medicines like amiodarone. L is lithium. Remember, the triad for diabetes is polyuria, polydipsia, and vision changes. Polyphagia is not really true, not really pliable, but vision changes is. How do we diagnose diabetes? And remember the robot, R2F3, random blood sugar, 2-hour glucose tolerance test, fasting, and the hemoglobin A1C. Remember, metabolic syndrome is too much insulin, and they become pudgy, and their cholesterol gets bad. Dawn phenomenon, blood sugar goes up as the sun comes up. You got to increase your MPH. Somogy means the blood sugar drops so much because you gave them too much sugar that their counter-regulatory hormones shot it up. You got to decrease insulin with Somogy. The counter-regulatory hormones are glucagon, comes from the pancreas, cortisol from the adrenal gland, and growth hormone from the pituitary. Remember the medications. We have the sponge squeezers, the sealing medications like the biguanides, the sensitizers, which is the TZDs, which are falling out of favor. They're falling out of maybe flavor and favor. Maybe they don't taste good. Maybe they're falling out of flavor and favor. Wow. But they're decreased reabsorbers, which are from the GI tract and the kidney. GU, cryptorchism. That T stands for torsion. The C stands for cancer. When we talk about a swollen testicle, remember, varicocele has all of the buzzwords in it. It doesn't transilluminate. It feels like a bag of worms. Oh, say, can you see? These are your kidney stones. Struvite, calcium, uric acid, and cysteine. BU and creatinine, is it pre-renal, renal, or post-renal? Remember, pre-renal, they're either dry or CHF, and the BU and creatinine is greater than 20 with a creatinine that's high. For kidney toxins, remember, most common is Motrin or NSAIDs, ACEs, contrast studies, and medication like gentamicin. Talk about the brain. If it's anterior circulation stroke, they have a problem with motor, vision, and verbal. If it's posterior stroke, they have vertigo and they get like seasick. Subdural hematoma is a venous bleed. Epidural hematoma is an arterial bleed. Epidural hematoma, they classically go unconscious, they wake up, and then they die. Remember, there's a differential diagnosis for any day of the week. What am I saying? Any day of the week, you can have a stroke. Please remember there's a bell up here, ladies and gentlemen. Bell's palsy can make you think stroke. But remember, Monday, it's a migraine. Tuesday, it's Todd's paralysis. Wednesday is Wernicke's. Thursday, it's temporal arteritis. Friday, it's functional, meaning they're playing games. Saturday, it's a systemic infection like syphilis, and on Sunday, it's sugar. Remember, no stroke is a stroke until you check a blood sugar. Peripheral neuropathies, Bell's palsy, it's cranial nerve 7, salt. Think about getting salt in the eye. Sarcoid, AIDS, Lyme, and tumor can give you Bell's palsy. We treat prednisone and acyclovir. Remember, Eaton-Lambert syndrome, they're strongest in the evening. Myasthenia gravis are stronger in the morning. E for eating is evening. M is for morning. Remember, migraine headaches, it's got to be episodic. You need 2 out of PUTA, pain unilateral, throbbing, and associated with activities. And SIN, the S is sensations like photophobia, and N is nausea. You need 2 out of the PUTA and 1 out of SN. Sick kid is wicked, wicked, wicked important. How do I know if a kid's got otitis media versus meningitis? tone, irritability, controllability, cry, labor? Are they appropriately stimulated by the environment and how they've been eating? Happy. Happy is a mnemonic for the sixth cause of EKG findings that will kill your patient with syncope. H is Holcomb. A is acute coronary syndrome. P is PE. The next P is prolonged QT. And the Y, there's two things on the stalk of the Y, WPW or Brugada. Remember dermatology. I like the purple plane. Remember the P's, purple, polygonal, papulon, pyritic, Wickham, striae, and remember the C on the nose? That's hepatitis C. You got to check for hepatitis C with lichen planus. This is a bagel. Looks like a bagel. That's bagel cell with pearly borders and telangiectasias. Remember, if it acts like a cancer, that's It's actinic keratosis. Actinic keratosis, it acts like a premalignant squamous cell. So it's squamous cell versus actinic keratosis. Remember, that's my girlfriend with polycystic ovarian syndrome. I buy her oyster ovaries and a pearl necklace. That's what the radiograph is going to show. Here is the cervix. The exocervix got squamous cell. The endocervix got columnar. At the squamocolumnar junctions where we do our pap smears and get our specimen for GC chlamydia. Here is Amsel's garden with clue cells, whiff test, pH greater than 4.5, and the discharge, a characteristic discharge. Remember, when looking for bacterial vaginosis, you're looking for Amsel's criteria. Remember Nagel's rule. Add 7 days minus 3 months. So you find the first day of the last period, add 7 days minus 3 months. That should give you the estimated date of confinement. Anybody who you're thinking of methotrexate, the HCG has got to be less than 5,000, and the size of the fetus on the ultrasound has got to be less than 3.5 centimeters. Anybody who's got high blood pressure over 20 weeks, green. It's pregnancy with hypertension, which we treat with methyldopa. Methyldopa gives you a lupus-like rash. They spill protein. Now it's way more concerning. Now it's preeclampsia. That's the yellow. If they have seizures, it's eclampsia that is severe and life-threatening. Remember HELP syndrome. Do you remember what HELP syndrome is? Guys, thank you for attending my conference. It was a blessing and a gift for you guys to allow me to speak to you. Please use this stuff. Allow this to pass your board so you can go on with your life. Take this information, teach to others. Good luck to you.